My name is Ford, and I was the project manager for the development you're about to see here.
What you see here is what the project looked like before it was handed to me. Lots of dirt. I started this video project about 2 years ago, and my intention was to make an employee video about the company I work for because you never really see any behind the scenes video of home building like you would, say, a smartphone. So I started shooting video once a week for the duration of the project, and what you're going to see here is what I captured. This was supposed to be a video for the homeowners, so that they could see what their neighborhood looked like before it was built, and to tell people about how awesome the company is, but I'm going to use this as a shameless promotion of myself. But before I get to that, I'll tell you more about the project. The community is called Elderberry in Portola Springs, which is in Irvine, California. The home sizes are close to 3,000 square feet and have a base price somewhere in the $1.2 million range. I was only about 3 phases away from completing this video project before I moved to offices, so we get to see what that project looked like from the beginning up until that point. I want to tell you about all the details that go into home building. What a lot of people don't know is that every detail, every aspect, gets a lot of attention. So every material that goes into the home is carefully curated, carefully selected to keep the best home. The design process takes a very long time because every square inch in the house has a purpose. And I honestly think that if there was a documentary series that was made about home building, I think it would be a great show. These homes are meticulously designed with countless revisions to deliver the best homes possible, and I know this because I was a part of it. Plans. It takes years to plan out the project. I used to take plans home to study them so that I would know everything. You see, the project manager is supposed to be the encyclopedia of the project. I played historian to decision maker. Everyone comes to the project manager for information. I was supposed to know everything. In the beginning I didn't, but with time, I got to know almost everything. Each set of plans has something like 300 pages, and that doesn't include everything. What it includes is structural details and engineering details, but everything else has to be selected after that. What kind of paint? What kind of stucco? How many layers? One thing I want to tell you guys about is expansion joints. Expansion joints are these things in the exterior of the wall of the home, and what they do is they expand and contract with heat. The walls are engineered so as the exterior heats up from the sun and cools down at night, all the expansion and contraction happens at the joint. And this keeps the walls from getting cracks like you would see in older homes. And I live in an older home, and let me tell you, I wish I had expansion joints. Here's a flight up the same street for the last 2 years. Notice the feel of the community before it's built to when it's nearly complete. Whatever the building code is, we beat it, and not by just a little. We design our homes to be ideally efficient. What that means is that we figure out each level of efficiency and how much that marginal cost would be. And then we take the ideal spot where efficiency meets cost to give the absolute best value you can get. We would do everything on paper first, over and over and over, then again and again and again. Then we'd build the frame of the house and bring out the entire team. There's over 50 people, from structural engineers to architects to landscape architects and all sorts of other specialists, who would walk the framing. Because even though everybody's been building houses for decades, when paper plans turn into real construction, things in real life are different. So then we make more changes. We'll spend all day walking the framed houses to make sure everything is absolutely perfect. And that's what I really respected about the way we did things. Even our division president walked the framing with us and pored over every detail. It was amazing. I spent a lot of time studying layouts and floor plans because it was one of those things that everyone at the company really wanted perfect in ways that homeowners wouldn't see, but would certainly experience. For example, we have really open floor plans on the first floor so that when family members are downstairs, they could be doing things in different rooms, but it feels like they're all together. It's really nice in the family dynamic. Every part of the home is really designed to benefit the homeowner. It's time to talk about me. I've experienced from acquisitions through entitlement, from project design to landscaping, from getting building plans approved to getting bonds exonerated after the project is done, and I'm all about doing it better. I even gave up a weekend to become a notary public so that I could reduce the amount of time it takes to process real estate documents. I've done a lot. I can build. One of the things I really liked about what I did was making the homes as customizable as possible. When you come into our design studio and decide you want to have a power outlet over here, no problem. We make it happen. You want some special exotic countertop that you want in there instead? We make it happen. I spent some time scrambling with the team to get special requests done, and sometimes these special requests came in at the last minute, and we'd still scramble to make it happen. That was the level of detail we worked on. We were pretty much obsessed with delivering the best home possible. I put a lot into this project and I'm proud of my work. I had a lot of highs and a lot of lows, a lot of trials and tribulations, but it was all a joy to build. Look how happy I was to build here. I really enjoy building. And if you do too, reach out to me.